Tony Doyle and Michelle Cornelius. Guys, we got off to the first night of racing last night in the Rotterdam Six Day. It looks strange, I guess, for the fans following at home. Was it strange as an expert to see this sort of racing? Can you walk us through what we saw, Michelle?
This was the first time I saw a first evening like this. It was so hard already in the first medicine. And also the second one was unbelievable. After 40, 50 laps, the first riders were in big problems. And it's a long time ago. I see a hard evening like yesterday.
Why is that? Why was it hard, do you think?
We talked about yesterday. It was maybe also 15 couples. It's a lot. So when you're in the front, you fight to stay in the front. So it keeps also the speed up. And I think that's a main reason. And a lot of good couples, a strong field. Yeah. So everybody from day one, they make a hard race.
A lot of road guys are out in this peloton as well. Tony, what did you see in the first night?
I think we saw some excellent racing. There was some serious action out there, and some of the stronger teams, they wanted to assert their authority, and there was no New Year's presents being given out. And so, as Michelle said, there was fantastic racing, and it takes you back to the good old days in the Ahoy Arena back in the 80s,
yeah.
When there was some serious racing from the off. And you saw the Danes, Morkov and Rasmussen, and Kaiser and Terpstra, and they've laid down the law and let them know that they're going to be in, the other 13 teams are going to be in for a hard 6 days of racing here.
Yeah,
88, back when you won. Now we're back to 2014. It looked like Elio and Nicky, they were the strongest out there. Was that the case? Were they the strongest? Or is it a matter of legs and head in this race?
I mean, they were very strong in both the Madisons, and they really excelled themselves in the final Madison. But, the Danes are very clever. They haven't ridden a 6 day for a couple of years, but Morkov and Rasmussen, they use their heads, and they are able to profit from all the work that Elio and Nicky were doing. And, that's why they won that final Madison.
Is that a blessing or is it a curse to be in the leader's position so early on? I mean, we saw the Danes really putting Elio and Nicky on the defense yesterday. So in the final Madison, how did you see that, Michelle?
No, I think it was also the tactic to make it very hard, because like we said yesterday, we have a very strong couple, Theo Bos and Brown, old Olympic champion. But they didn't give the time to come in the race, because they make it so hard that they cannot use to each other, and they already lost a lot of laps. And I think that was the main reason why the front couples now make it so hard. Mm. And like Anthony say, Rasmussen and Morkov, they're very, very smart. And I hear Morkov is riding very well, so it can be a big fight.
And Tony, going into the second night of racing, I mean, do you think we're going to see the Danes take the lead already, or how do you think the second night's going to play out?
I think we're going to see similar to the first night. I think there's going to be flat out racing from the start. I think that the guys that struggled last night, unless they haven't had a good night's sleep, they're going to be in for a right kicking this evening. And so hopefully Graham Brown is going to be able to find his track legs. And he's a real class rider, so his first 6 days find it very tough. So for him and Theo, it is a baptism of fire. But I think the Danish pair and the Dutch-Belgian team of Kaiser and Terpstra, I think they're going to be tearing up the racing right from the start.
And the Belgians are right there, De Ketel and De Boost. They're in third place, if I think it's correct, on the standings. Those guys, do you think they're going to come to the fore in the second night of racing, Michelle?
Yeah, they're also very smart to stay in the front, not lose so many points and not losing laps. So they can also be the surprise. And what's going to happen is the teams who have now big problems, they want to have a revenge. And they can be very important for the klassement, because there's also coming a payback time.
Yeah.
So that they want to hurt Kaiser and Terpstra. So it can be very interesting.
Michelle, you're a betting man. Who will be at the top of the leaderboard tonight?
It's one of the three, I think, but... I think still Kaiser and Terpstra, they show they want to be the leaders. And I think they're also fighting to stay the leaders. But Morkov and Rasmussen and the Belgium team, they stay close. So it's not so important who's the leader, but I think Terpstra and Kaiser wants to be the leader.
Tony?
Yeah, I mean, the three teams that we've been talking about, but a team that's very strong and dark horses, Jens Morris and Wim Strutinger, yep, riding very intelligently. When they raced in Amsterdam, they were getting stronger and stronger. And, you know, Jens Morris is always there. Strutinger's very aggressive. And I think they could profit from the other three top teams fighting it out between themselves.
There you go. All right. We'll see you tonight. Thank you.